Well, hello. It's the dog. The dog, the bird, and me. Yes, it's Chico, Dexter, though not necessarily in that order. And yours truly, back with a sort of Tech Tuesday video. And I say sort of because it's not a tech video at all. But instead, we'll be editing, processing, call it what you want, and then printing the image we took in Saturday's video at Bracelet Bay with my... with my Nikon D700 and 17-28mm f2.8 lens. This gorgeous, gorgeous kit, you know. If you've not watched that video, then I suggest you do that first. And there's a link above somewhere to it. And if I forget, it'll be in the description below. Right then, if you have now watched it or even seen it already, what I'm going to do now is get that image up in Lightroom. Well, process it, really, to see how ancient in digital terms files stack up in bang up to the minute, you know, Adobe software. So what I'll do now is fire up the old M2 Pro Mac Mini and start a screen recording. Now, this shouldn't take too long, as I was quite careful in the image taking process to get a nice balanced exposure, and it's not exactly a complex image to begin with anyway. Onwards to the mainframe. Oh, remember them?
What did I say? During the meanwhilest.
During the meanwhilest? No, no, not that at all.
Right then. So here we are in Adobe's Lightroom. And this isn't the same image I showed on Saturday, but it's near as damn it identical. And it's just a little bit more, I think, wave action down here. But no matter. First thing I'm going to do is crop it and check for level. Now, I want to print this as a 16 by 12, so that's a 4 by 3 aspect ratio. And I want all the rocks in. And I'm going to break a major photographic rule now, and that is having the horizon smack bang in the middle of the image. But, you know, rules are there to be broken, aren't they? And if I don't like it at the end, then, you know, it's tough, isn't it? Right, let's check for level, because there's no level meter in the Nikon D700 camera. And even though I'd set it with the XH2 first, there's no guarantee that this is going to be bob on, and it's not. So right then, if I take that crop off now, go to 100%, go to the top, and you can see there now that that horizon, what was a ship there, that horizon is pretty well straight. And we can also see zoomed into 100%, just how much detail the D700 caught or captured in these rocks. Now, overall, it's quite a pleasing, balanced exposure. I shot it in manual mode, and I set the meter to, I think, around about 1/3 of a stop under, maybe, or if it wasn't, it was plumb on the metered exposure. What I'm going to do first off is deal with the sky, because it's too bright. Okay, now I'm going to create a mask over the sky. Now I could select the sky, but that is pulling up some parts of the sea, and in this case you don't really need to do that, because we got a dead flat level horizon with nothing breaking it. So I can just get rid of that and draw a linear gradient, as I would normally do in these instances, down to the horizon, thusly. There we are. It's going to give me a nice gradation, and I'm going to drop this by 2 stops. There we are. Let's bring in plenty of detail into the sky. I also want to warm it up a touch. On the day, the sun was kind of like over here, There's a bit of side light onto the image, and the sky was quite warm. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to boost the saturation just a little. And I'm going to bring in some texture, clarity, not an awful lot, and a touch of dehaze into the image. And we can see from this as well, the sensor in my D700 is spotless. Spotless sensor, that's nice, isn't it? There we go. And I haven't cleaned it. I haven't cleaned it either. Right, so that's the sky. That's the sky dealt with. I'm going to create a new mask now to deal with these shadows. So let's select subject and see what it does with that. There we are. Just need to add a little with a brush down here, that's all. Okay, what I want to do now is lift the shadows to about 40. Add in some micro contrast with texture and clarity. And as you can see, this increase in contrast is brought some more shadows in. So I'm just going to raise that a little bit more to 50. And I also want to increase the saturation in the rocks, because there's a little bit of, you can see it, a little bit of green lichen in there, or algae or whatever, and I want to bring that out. So I'm going to bring the saturation up quite high. So that's now dealt with that. Now the next area I want to deal with is this sort of wave action here. So what I'm going to do now is create a new mask, select the sky, invert it, and I am going to intersect it with a luminance range. So what I'm going to do now, this is like in the old days, this was it luminosity masking they used to call it, only this is much, much simpler. I just want to affect these areas here. So if I drag this luminance slider, as follows, to there. What I want to do now is increase the texture again and the clarity. There we are, that's quite nice in this area, but only affecting these luminosity ranges. And let's increase the whites up just a little, not much, just a little. There we go. I think I quite like that as is. Now what I'm going to do now is, because I want to print this image, I wouldn't normally add any sharpening, because if you have a look at these rocks, I focused around about here, and at F13 I'm going to get all this and pretty well to infinity in focus. So I am going to add, I think down a little bit of softness in this corner. So I will add a degree of sharpening. Now, if you remember back to my old days, I don't sharpen Fujifilm RAW files in Adobe Lightroom at all. Nothing to do with the wormy artifact problem, but because they come out with the camera sharp enough. But if I remember in the old days, I used to take the amount to about 100. Leave the radius at 1 pixel, bring the detail to about 40, and then we're going to mask out the majority of this image and just sharpen the edges. So I'll take the masking to about there. There we are. That's pretty sharp. It's still a little bit soft down here. Maybe diffraction, possibly. Possibly a bit of lens softness in the corners, because it is quite an old lens. But I am pretty happy with that. What I want to do now is I'm going to create a soft proof copy and choose the paper I'm going to print it on, which is Photo Speed Pearl 290. And this kind of gives me what my result will be. Do I want to sharpen it a little bit more? Maybe I do. Maybe I want to sharpen it a little bit more for the print. So let's bring that up a little bit more. That's quite crunchy now, isn't it? That's pretty sharp. Even not down here. I think it's probably a lens issue, to be honest. It's a as near as damn it, 20-year-old lens. I'd be surprised if it wasn't a little bit soft in the corners, even at f/13. It's probably a little bit of lens softness, a little bit of diffraction coming in, to be honest, at that aperture. Right. I'm really happy with that. The sky's clean. There's a little bit there which is not a dust spot. It's actually a break in the cloud. Yeah, so I am quite happy with that. Do I want to deal with that? Do I deal with that? Let's see. Oh yeah, it's gone altogether. You'll never see it again in your life. Right, I'm going to leave this contrail. Leave the little ship on the horizon. I quite like that. Hang on, let's go. Look, that's not bad for a 12 megapixel camera. That ship's got to be 10 miles away. Maybe 5. I don't know. I'm not familiar with the nautical distances of the Bristol Channel, but there we are. Right, what I'm going to do now then is print this image. And I've already set this up to print on my chosen paper, which is going to be that. Print resolution 300 pixels per inch, print sharpening standard, media type glossy. Set that to that. What size is this image? Let's go to library. Where is it? You're looking at 4256 by 2832. So if I go to my calculator here and go 2832 divided by 12, that comes to 236 pixels per inch. 236, there we are. Pixels per inch. That then means that the printer is matching with the file. Right, I'm going to print this, and once that's done, I'll show you the finished image, both on screen and on paper. Right, well, that is the finished image, and here it is on a screen. If you have a good old look at, and here it is. He said, "Turn around." In print, I'm really very happy. It's a lovely. It's come out really, really, really well. Plenty of detail in the rocks. Perhaps could have done with a touch more print detail there, but you know, for a well, it turned out to be a what size file was it? I can't remember. Was it about wasn't 12 in the end, was it? It was, hang on, I'll go back to Lightroom and I'll find out exactly what the resolution was. Times. Oh, it is a 12 megapixel file. There we are. I thought I'd cropped it. Oh well. So it shouldn't really be 12 megapixels. It should be less than. I think what it is. This is giving me the native resolution, isn't it? Of the file. That's okay, because when I did it worked out the print density, I did it on this axis, which didn't change, so that's fine. We will be back on Saturday with one of our music videos. You'll be so pleased to hear. It's my choice for three classic heavy rock debut albums. There we are. That shook the world. Right. We will see you on Saturday. And until then, just be nice, all right? And we'll see you on Saturday. Ta-ra.